Hello, my name is Tanya Vos, and in this video I'm going to talk about testing at the GUI level, the graphical user interface level of a software application. So testing at the graphical user interface level is an important phase in testing because the graphical user interface is where all functionality of an application comes together. So it's where the user interface interacts with all their underlying code while a user is exercising the functions on the user interface. So if we test at the user interface, we can execute the whole system. So in that way, GUI testing is kind of system testing. So testing at the GUI level is important also because most applications have graphical user interfaces. Computers, tablets, smartphones, all the software that run on these devices have a graphical user interface. And what we see is that also safety critical applications more and more get advanced graphical user interfaces, as you can also see here on the slide. We see a graphical user interface for a medical device, and we see a graphical user interface for a car. Testing at the graphical user interface is also important because that's where you find those errors that your clients would find if they use your system. So if you test at the graphical user interface level, you test from the client's and the user's perspective. So now let's see what is graphical user interface testing, and we start with explaining what is a graphical user interface. A graphical user interface contains graphical objects that we call widgets. So widgets are, for example, menus, text boxes, buttons, scroll bars, etc. On the slide you see an example of the graphical user interface of the VLC application, and here you see that we have a menu with all kinds of buttons we can click on. We have a sliding widget and we have some other button we can click on, and all these graphical objects together are the widgets of the graphical user interface. So these widgets together, they form a hierarchy, and this hierarchy is called a widget tree. So following up on the example we saw before of the VLC user interface, here we see again the user interface, and here we see the widget tree. So the root of the tree is the whole window, which is where the graphical user interface is in, and we see there is a button underneath it, which is this button. There is a slider, which is this slider, and there is a whole menu bar, which consists of all these menu items. So then we go one level down in the tree, and this menu has a menu for media, a menu for playback, for audio, etc., until the help. So these are these menu buttons up here. And obviously the tree is bigger and goes into more level down because all these menu items have a drop-down menu. It doesn't fit on the slide, so it's not here, but you can see here, if we open the media menu, all kinds of other things come out, and these should be in a tree under this media widget. So a graphical user interface are graphical objects called widgets, and these widgets form a hierarchy in a widget tree. So this is an example widget tree, a typical widget tree of a big application. You see, it's we need to go with small examples because if we go for the real examples, it's too big to fit on the slide. But just to give you an impression how these widget tree would look in for real applications. So we have widgets, we have a widget tree, and all these widgets have properties. And these properties have specific value at runtime. So following with our example, we had this widget tree here with the window, the button, the menus, and the slider. And here we see, for example, that this button has all kinds of properties. Some of the properties are here on the slide, but there's many, many, many properties that we can get from every widget on a graphical user interface. For example, this button has a role, which is a button that can be clicked on. It is enabled because we can actually click on it and something will happen. And the title is, for example, volume off. Because as we can see here, this button currently has the volume off. And there's more properties like the X and the Y coordinates, the width, etc. For the slider, the same. The role is a slider because you can slide. It's not enabled because as you can see at this moment, this thing is not enabled, so we cannot slide with it. And the title is volume slider, and it has some X, Y, and other attributes. And so all these widgets in this tree have properties. So now the state of a graphical user interface is this widget tree with the hierarchy of the widget plus all the values of the properties of a specific widget. And a user that can do an action on this graphical user interface, like click, type, drag, drop, slide, etc., can actually cause a state change. This is reflected by the image here. So we are in this state where we have this button and this slider. If the user does a click on this button here, we go to a next state where this is now enabled because you can change the volume and the slider has a different color because you can now actually slide. So this is a state change which is caused by a user clicking on a button. So looking at the trees we saw before, this is the tree we had before with the button have property title volume off and the slider has property enabled false. If we do this click, then afterwards the button has volume on because the volume is on and the slider is now enabled true. So this is another visualization to see how a user action can actually change the state of the graphical user interface, and this state is represented by the widget tree. So then, what is GUI testing if that's our graphical user interface? So if we have a graphical user interface with widgets and actions and state changes, then sequences of GUI actions are actually our test sequences. So sequences of click, drag, drop, type, and some inputs here and there for the text boxes, those are our test sequences. And then what we need on top of that is to specify an oracle. A test oracle that indicates whether after we have clicked something and we are in a different state, the state is correct or not. So for example, if we look at a very simple test for Microsoft Word, imagine we want to open Microsoft Word, click on the View menu, click on the Media Browser, and select a picture into the document. This is our test sequence. And then we want to specify a test oracle that says no failure occurs when we are doing all these state changes, no error message pops up when we do all these state changes, and after the last step, the picture is actually in the document. So this looks like this. We open Microsoft Word. We click on the menu view, we select the media browser, and we drag a picture in the document. So that's our test sequence, and we apply an oracle in every state and an oracle at the end. So you can imagine that if you have to do this in a manual way, this is very tedious because you have to execute the same clicks over and over again. This is tiresome and boring because after every time our software changes, we have to rerun these tests all over again. This is called regression testing. And if something is tiresome and boring, it's error prone and costly. So we cannot do graphical user interface testing manually. We actually need to automate that. And in the next video, we're going to talk about ways to automate graphical user interface testing.